We want to solve and graph each inequality and then express the solution using interval notation. The method for solving a linear inequality is the same as solving a linear equation, except when solving a linear inequality, if we multiply or divide by a negative, we must reverse the inequality symbol. Looking at our first example, notice we have variable terms on both sides of the inequality. So the first step is to get the variable terms on one side. And since we normally prefer to have the variables on the left side of an inequality, to undo this positive 3x, we'll subtract 3x on both sides of the inequality. So now we have 2x minus 3x, that's negative 1x, or negative x, minus 6 is greater than, well, 3x minus 3x is 0, that's why we did that. So we have negative 11. And again, it might be helpful to think of this as negative 1x. So we need to undo the subtraction here, as well as the multiplication between the negative 1 and x. And we always undo the addition or subtraction first. So to undo minus 6, we'll add 6 to both sides. So we have negative 1x, this would be 0, is greater than negative 11 plus 6 is negative 5. And now to undo this multiplication, we'll divide both sides by a negative 1. And since we're dividing by a negative, we do have to reverse the inequality symbol. So here we'll have positive 1x, or x. And if this is greater than, and then we reverse it, we'll have x is less than. And then negative 5 divided by negative 1 is positive 5. So our solution is x is less than positive 5. So to graph this, since 5 is not in this interval, we'll make an open point on 5, and then for values less than 5, we have an arrow to the left. As we move further and further to the left, we would be approaching negative infinity. Knowing this is helpful to write this interval using interval notation. We want the interval from 5 to negative infinity, not including 5. So we'll have to include a negative infinity here and a 5. And we'll use a rounded parenthesis to the left of negative infinity. And then to show that it does not include positive 5, we make another rounded parenthesis here. So now we've expressed the solution three ways: as an inequality, as a graph, and using interval notation. Looking at our second example, again we have variable terms on both sides of the inequality. So we need to either subtract 5x on both sides or subtract 8x on both sides. If we prefer to have the variable on the left side, we would have to subtract 5x on both sides. So 8x minus 5x is 3x, minus 4, greater than or equal to, this would be 0, and we have 14. And now we need to undo the subtraction and this multiplication, and we always undo the subtraction first, so we'll add 4 to both sides. So we'll have 3x, this would be 0, greater than or equal to 18. And the last step is to divide both sides by 3. Now we're dividing by a positive 3, so we do not reverse the inequality symbol. So we have x greater than or equal to 18 divided by 3 is equal to positive 6. Now notice in this case, 6 does satisfy this inequality, because 6 is greater than or equal to 6. So to show this graphically, we make a closed point on 6, and then for numbers greater than 6, we draw an arrow to the right, which would be approaching positive infinity. Therefore, for interval notation, we have the interval from 6 to infinity, but to show that it includes 6, we make a square bracket here, and then for infinity, we always use a rounded parenthesis. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.